Hello from the studios at Pascual Bravo University. Each country has their own transport office or agency when talking about the permits or licenses to operate motor vehicles. Some places of the world separate their motor vehicles. For example, motorcycles based on their cubic centimeters, cc, and therefore the restrictions to operate said vehicle. Other places keep track of the behavior of their drivers via a system of points, and other countries have standard systems with a series of tests aiming to demonstrate that the driver can drive in their country or region. Some places emphasize more on knowing how to drive under heavy rain, snow, or the prevalent weather conditions. For instance, in Colombia, there is a standard system with some specific brackets according to the type of vehicle that will be driven. The Colombian system also encompasses local centers where people can learn how to drive and then apply for the driving license. Some of the categories are driving cars, riding motorcycles, driving taxis and buses, driving heavy machinery, among other vehicles. In order for a person to obtain a driving license in Colombia, the person must attend the driving lesson course and the practical driving lessons regardless of the vehicle. Some details may vary from country to country. In Europe, through driving courses offered by the European Car Commissioner, drivers learn the value of tires in preventing road accidents. To achieve a fundamental level of awareness, driving courses teach how to react to different situations, like slalom. This exercise is done to learn how to take the wheel correctly. The advice of the monitors is to imagine that the steering wheel is a clock and to place your hands on 2 and 10. It is also essential to learn how to take curves without crossing hands. Another situation is emergency braking, where drivers become aware of the importance of keeping tires in good condition, and why cars mount systems like ABS, plus how much time and space a car needs to stop safely. Cornering is to learn at what speed you have to take a curb and where to step on the accelerator so that the car advances as stable as possible. And understeer and oversteer is usually the part that students like the most, but is also one of the most important in terms of safety. With practice, drivers learn to control the car when it skids from the front and or rear. I am Hannah, and this has been a Pascual Bravo English documentary. Until next time, good luck with English.